Hey guys, Lexi here. First thing I want to do is apologize. I haven't exactly made a video in a long time, and there's a couple that I kind of want to get out. I know that I'm going to be doing some reviews soon, especially for some of the new models that I've gotten, but today I've seemed to have a lot of questions lately on how I customize some of my models. My latest customized video was for my stablemates version of Zenyatta and Baby Z, so now I'm going to show you how I exactly did that. So for everybody that kind of keeps up with Zenyatta and her website and all of her news, it is awesome to finally know that Baby Z now has a name, and his new name is Cosmic One, and I think that is an amazing name for him. So in honor of that, and the fact that I have my stablemate version of Zenyatta and Baby Z, and then traditional versions of Little Z as a foal, I think it would be a absolute perfect time to make traditional adult slash yearling of Cosmic One. Since I don't exactly think that Briar might come out with a traditional version of him unless he does really fantastic in races, which we're all hoping he does. So this will probably be a long video, but I'll probably upload it in parts of how I customize my Briars. Keep in mind, I have not been customizing very long, only for a couple of months, and I have a lot to learn and a lot I need to practice, but I will show you where I am so far. Alright, so the first thing that you obviously need is some sort of a reference picture. Always know what horse you want to make before you start painting it. Don't start sanding it and get it all prepped and ready and then have no idea what you're doing. Which is actually something I started to do with this horse. I knew I really wanted to make another custom, and I really want to create my own spirit character, my, you know, like my original character. And I was going to do it on this mold, however, this mold is a colt and mine is a female, and so I'd have to do a lot of extensive work, and my horse is also a Mustang, and I don't know. I just don't think that this model represents her very well, so that's why I decided to go with Cosmic One. Also, instead of a reference picture, I have the foal of Baby Z. I'm going to be using the Briar traditional foal as my reference. For tools, to start out, the first thing that I always do is to prep my model, I sand the bejesus out of it. I know a lot of people will only sand the seams to get rid of the seam marks. However, all of the models that I tend to customize on, they're very old models. Like, I'm not too sure how old this model is. Really, really old. This was one of the original Black Beauty models, and I love Black Beauty, but I just don't think that this model represents him very well. I have my little Black Beauty Classic, and if I'm going to get a Black Beauty Traditional, I want the one that's on the silver mold. I don't think that this one represents him very well, so, just because I don't know, I'm weird. So, some of the older models, they have a lot of bumps under the plastic, and you can probably actually see some right about in here. So what I try to do is I sand those bumps out to make it so the body itself is as smooth as it possibly can get without ruining the actual mold itself. Now, I originally tried to reposition this guy and move his head up, so it was kind of like he was like whinnying with his head up, and it didn't work at all. However, I did manage to completely mess his muzzle up, so he's gonna be a special pony. Yeah, like I said, still not exactly that great at this yet. So, the tools that I start with when I start prepping this guy is I use a little tiny sanding pad like this. You can go to your crafting store. I literally bought this for a dollar. It's really easy, nice and simple, does a good job, lasts a pretty good time. I also use my little etching tool. I use this just in case there is a spot that I really want to get at that I can't really get at with the sander. I don't really have to use this sometimes, but it is nice to have. So, after we are done sanding it, I'm gonna sand this thing and then I'm gonna start recording again. Alright guys, so welcome to the next part of my little customizing video. So, as you can see, I got him fully sanded down and I washed him off and got all the little dust off him, and I have applied my primer. So now he is all white and very pretty. I don't prime the tail, obviously, because that's gonna be what I'm gonna be holding on to as I'm painting him. Obviously, he's gonna be a little Cosmic One. So, this is the way I do it. I'm sure there's a lot better ways to do this, and I'm gonna try something maybe different this time with this model. I noticed that for Baby Z, his legs and his tail, they're pretty much black, and then the rest of his body is a very, very dark chocolate with his lighter parts. So, I normally just start with a regular layer of brown acrylic. I am going to be looking for a darker brown to do this, because this brown dries really, really light. And if you notice, this is my stablemate's version of Cosmic One. And he's actually, I know it's kind of hard to see, but he's actually a lot lighter than my traditional foal. I'm gonna do my best to try to match the color as best I can. So I'm gonna start putting some layers of my paint on, and when I start doing this, I basically have three brushes that I mainly use. Unfortunately, I need to go get new brushes, so this is gonna be the one that I'm gonna be using to actually put the layers of paint on him. It's very big. I actually prefer something a lot smaller, but it's kind of all I have right now, so bear with me. So this is my body brush, and this is going to be my detailing slash little crevices brush, I suppose. And then obviously this is my pastelling brush, which we'll get to when I actually start pastelling him. So I will put my layers of paint on, and we will go from there. Alright guys, well, this is my first layer for Cosmic One, and I know it looks pretty ridiculous right now. The acrylic paint that I'm actually using is really, really nice because even though you can see ridiculously terrible brush strokes, it dries in a very, very solid color. If you actually go back and watch my custom video for Baby Zenyatta and, Baby Z, rather, and Zenyatta, you will see that the very first layer of paint on them was actually exactly like this. And every single layer that I add, it is going to get more solid and solid and solid until he is a nice, rich, deep brown color. And once he's that deep brown color, we can start the pastelling. So let's skip ahead and get right to that. Alright guys, so now that we have all of our layers on him, as you can see, he now has a very nice, almost just deep, rich, chocolatey brown color. And if you notice, he doesn't look like the very first layer, which was just a bunch of really funny brush strokes. So the next part that I'm going to be doing is after I get, you know, the good solid layer of dark on him, I'm going to now be focusing on the pastels. So the ones that I just have here are several different types of brown. However, they are a type of reddish brown. They're not just like a basic brown. So there are actually only two pastels that I use for my dark bay horses. And it is the dark reddish brown. Please focus. Thank you. It is the dark reddish brown and black.